and live in tiny houses of the same mistakes we made. Cause there are too many of us in tiny houses here and there. I'll say now somewhere, but you.
Doesn't need to be young to dislike institutions. But the dreary fact remains that even in the darkest ages, it was institutions which made society work. And if civilization is to survive, society must somehow be made to work. I hold a number of beliefs that have been repudiated by the liveliest intellects of our time. I believe that order is better than chaos. Creation better than destruction. I prefer gentleness to violence, forgiveness to vendetta. On the whole, I think that knowledge is preferable to ignorance, and I am sure that human sympathy is more valuable than ideology. I believe that in spite of recent triumphs of science, men haven't changed much in the last 2,000 years. And in consequence, we must still try to learn from history. History is ourselves. I also hold one or two beliefs that are more difficult to put shortly. For example, I believe in courtesy, the ritual by which we avoid hurting other people's feelings by satisfying our own egos. And I think we should remember that we are part of a great whole, which, for convenience, we call nature. All living things are our brothers and sisters. Above all, I believe in the God-given genius of certain individuals, and I value a society that makes their existence possible.
After he had journeyed, and his feet were sore, and he was tired, he came upon an orange grove, and he rested. And he lay in the cool. While he rested, he took to himself an orange and tasted it. And it was good. And he felt the earth to his spine, and he asked. And he saw the tree above him, and the stars, and the veins in the leaf, and the light, and the balance. And he saw magnificent perfection, whereon thought of himself in balance, and he knew he was.
Opportunity is created by a revolution in the technology of war. Power is increasingly defined not by mass or size, but by mobility and swiftness. Influence is measured in information. Safety is gained in stealth. And force is projected on the long arc of precision-guided weapons.
And he thought of those he angered, for he was not a violent man. And he thought of those he hurt, for he was not a cruel man.
A Predator reconnaissance drone searches for the convoy. It's flown by remote control from Kyrgyzstan in Central Asia, 1,000 kilometers away. Live video is fed to command headquarters around the world and to an AC-130 gunship slowly moving in for the kill.
Is your copy? the sensor to shooter link was compressed to the time it takes to transmit digital data.
There are people coming out of the mosque right now.
Let's go. Roll it in.
Precision enables the AC-130 gunners to avoid the mosque while picking off the enemy. What looks like a video game is a face of modern warfare.
Get back on those guys. Here we go.
Those small, white, moving forms are killed.
Hi, this is Craig Jester.
One after another.
Okay, get the other guy.
After another.
They're selling postcards of the hanging. They're painting passports brown. The beauty parlor. All filled with sailors. You know the circus is in town.
Network-centric warfare is really a theory of war for the information age. When you have a new source of power, a new dominant source of power, you need a new theory of war to exploit it.
One hand is tied to the tightrope walker. You know the other one is in his pants.
We got that overpass when that flew off. Yeah, you stand there. Why?
What do you
see when you're standing
there?
Yeah, you did. Why you fucking liar, piece of shit? Fucking stand there.
Arms up. There's Lady Nine looking out tonight on desolation road.
Our security will require transforming the military you will lead, a military that must be ready to strike at a moment's notice in any dark corner of the world.
Simple presence of our warships here on guard duty makes it more difficult for the bad guys and the semi-bad guys, then we've accomplished a lot. And in the next step, if, together with the coalition, we succeed in focusing our mission, then I think we will have a good chance going forward.
Weapon receives GPS coordinates from anywhere from 3 to 7 satellites, takes that data, calculates the position of the target to attack, and then the weapon can really go off and execute that regardless of the environmental conditions in the battle space.
It's about time we begin it.
Any dark corner of the world.
To turn the world around. It's about time we start to make it. The dream we've always known. It's about time we start to live it. The family of man. It's about time. It's about changes. And it's about time.
Precision-guided weapons.
It's about peace. And it's about plenty. And it's about time. It's about you and me together. And it's about time.
When you have a new source of power, a new dominant source of power, you need a new theory of war to exploit it.
These programs have been filled with great works of genius. In architecture, sculpture and painting, in philosophy, poetry and music, in science and engineering. There they are. You can't dismiss them. And they're only a fraction of what Western man has achieved in the last 1,000 years. Often after setbacks and deviations, at least as destructive as those of our own time, Western civilization has been a series of rebirths. Surely this should give us confidence in ourselves. But it's lack of confidence more than anything else that kills a civilization. We can destroy ourselves by cynicism and disillusion just as effectively as by bombs. 50 years ago, W.B. Yeats, who was more like a man of genius than anyone I've ever known, wrote a prophetic poem. And in it he said, "Things fall apart. The center cannot hold. Mere anarchy is loosed upon the world. The blood-dimmed tide is loosed, and everywhere the ceremony of innocence is drowned. The best lack all conviction, while the worst are full of passionate intensity. Well, that was certainly true between the wars, and it damn nearly destroyed us. Is it true today? Not quite, because good people have convictions, rather too many of them. The trouble is that there is still no center. The moral and intellectual failure of Marxism has left us with no alternative to heroic materialism. And that isn't enough. One may be optimistic, but one can't exactly be joyful at the prospect before us.
And he thought of those he angered, for he was not a violent man. And he thought of those he hurt, for he was not a cruel man. And he thought of those he frightened, for he was not an evil man. And he understood. He understood himself. Upon this, he saw that when he was of anger, or knew hurt, or felt fear, it was because he was not understanding. And he learned compassion. And with his eye of compassion, he saw his enemies like unto himself. And he learned love. Then he was answered.
I alone can fix it.
Just
Target captured. Amazing.
Weapons away.